Hello guys, my name is Mohammed and welcome to episode 2 of C++ tutorial series. So in this tutorial we're going to continue with C++. I'm going to show you a deep understanding of what you can do with print statements. So there are a lot of functionality in print statement that you can include in it. So you can define as many input statements, as many print statements as you want. But don't forget that the code is used to define a print statement, like other programming languages like Python that uses prints to define a print statement. So in C++, we use code to define a print statement. So we have these guys right here. We can also add something like, what is your name? Right? So we have print statements. Don't forget that to output a string, you have to use it within the double quote. So within these double quotes, that is why a string will be. So basically, if we are going to get rid of this double quotes, we're going to get an error. So we'll put an end line here, and if I execute this, you'll see the error that we will get. As you can see, we have an error. So to output something on screen, you have to put it within the double quote. That is when it will specify that this guy right here that I'm outputting is a string. So we have our quote, then string, then this guy right here. Don't forget to put the extraction operators, because they are very important. Without them, there will not be a quote. This code will not work and this string will not work. So put the after statement, put the insertion operators, insertion operator, the insertion operator. So what if we get rid of this guys right here and just put after the string we put the semicolon? So you will see what will happen. So without the end line, there will not be a line. As you can see, we have hello guys, then what is your name without going to the new line. So we don't have a new line, then we will output what is your name on the same line as hello guys. So without that end line, we are not going to output a new line. We are just going to put the same code that follows that code that is without the new line. So new line are kind of important to make your code or those texts kind of easy to read and all of that. We have hello guys and what is your name. So you can output as many codes as you want in your program. So what if I want to tap this hello guys to forward? I will use the backslash and T. So this backslash and T make us move forward, right? So we move this hello guys forward. So let's see what will happen. So as you can see, we have a tab right here, and then hello guys. So, and then what is your name? So hello guys, a tab, has a tab, and then hello guys, and then what is your name? So we have hello guys, what is your name? So tab here move a kind of 4 space forward, or 5 or 6, depending on what you want or what your computer is, or what you specify in the div C++ editor or all of that. So we have backward slash then T to tab the text kind of far from the margin of the program. So to put a new line, of course you can get rid of this end line and put a new line without the end line. We can put backward slash and N. So this backward slash and N means go to the new line, right? So you can also go to the new line with backward slash and N, and you can see what happened. Backward slash and N, and you can see hello guys first, what is your name second. So if we want to add a blank line, then a new line, you'll see that we will use backslash N, then another backslash N, and you can see what happened. as you can see, we have hello guy, then an empty line, then what is your name? So this is pretty cool and awesome. And you have created your first print statement and printing program. So you can print things in your screen and show it to your friends that this is my first C++ program. I print something on the screen and this is awesome, man. So this kind of things make you have this kind of fun, curiosity to create big applications. So if you're gonna create a big application, a calculation application, XY application of that, if you heard that, I don't want you to hear. So you have our main, and then codes, hello guys, and return. So this return, like I said, and our program, and this curly brace, and this main is a function that every C++ program, like I said, must have a main function. We have an int main function, then our program. But this guys, let me tell you something. All of these spaces that I'm leaving is to keep the application beautiful and organized. But the white space are irrelevant. You can keep them, you can create as many spaces as you want. You can just keep them without putting the space. You can also not put the space. So to keep it a quite neat application, we can use space to kind of put the difference or to make a statement, as a statement, to make them beautiful looking applications. So I guess this is the end of this video. If you like this video, click on the like button. Otherwise, stay tuned for my next amazing video tutorial episode.